What up, everybody? So here we go. Got another one of these things for ya, where I just talk a lot. So this is my review of the Fineco FX-3V. I have quite a few Fineco quads now, and I actually like them all, and I like this one. this is has voice controls, which you use this included headset with, and it has a set list of commands that you speak into the microphone and then it performs them. That's something that's fun once. And you know, I think maybe beginners or kids, my daughter loves this thing. She loves using the voice control. So some of the younger kids out there, maybe that would be fun for them, but it's not like you can, you know, just fly it with voice command. You still have to give throttle and stuff. But it does have it, and it actually works pretty good. It, you know, sometimes it doesn't recognize my command, but it's not very often. Most of the time it does exactly what you ask it to do, and it's pretty cool. So let's talk about the bad real quick. It has this protective ring prop guards, and there's actually more. These go on here like this, so it's got more prop guard protection than any other quad I've seen out there. I took these off right away. They just unclip. These ones here, you would have to actually clip. And Freak told me not to, because then you can't put the canopy on. But I think if you clipped it right, maybe it would still hold the canopy on. I don't know. But he might be right. So, it does, you know, I know that this would fly a little bit better without these. It does have a tendency sometimes to dip, and that's from the, you know, vortex that you get, the prop backwash, and, you know, it would fly better without them, but they work, you know. They're very good at catching tree limbs. But, so this isn't great for me. The yaw is pretty slow, not painfully slow, but it's not very fast. But this has a really nice pitch angle and high. So even with the slow yaw, turning it's pretty good. It turns pretty quick with, combined with the pitch. So, I'm not too mad at the yaw, but it, you know, a little bit faster would be beneficial to most quads. Just a little bit. I don't want them to spin like the XS1 or the H20 or something. I dislike super fast yaws as much as I dislike super slow yaws. But just a little bit faster and this thing would be, you know, much improved. The lights aren't super great. It has LEDs on the points here. And it's red in the back and then blue on the sides and green in the front. You can fly it at night. It's totally visible. They're just not great. You know, that's about all the bad. I like this thing. It has a nice pitch angle, and you can get this thing moving pretty fast despite these prop ring things. So it's pretty fast. It's nimble. It's really durable. It's got these little bouncy landing feet and these prop guards, and I've crashed the heck out of this one. Doing the voice control, like trying it out. They have a couple pre-programmed like routes that it'll do, and more than a few times I've let it get away from me and I've crashed it. But it's hit the fence quite a few times too, and it still looks pretty good. It's got a little paint off the nose there, but this thing looks awesome. I mean, to me it does. You know, I guess we all have our own preferences and opinions, but I think this thing looks cool as heck. I mean, it's like a sleek little spaceship. I like, you know, weird different designs. This one's definitely different, especially if you have these extra prop ring things on it. It looks crazy. But so it's fun. The flight times are not super long. Oh man, I didn't grab the battery, but with the battery, which I believe is a 350 milliamp hour battery, you only get about 5 minutes of flight time. It has an incredibly long LVC. It's probably a minute, you know, at least, maybe two. It's incredibly long. But it's also kind of hard to see in the daytime because of it doesn't have super bright LEDs. But the LVC is pretty long. So it flips very nice. It gives itself a bit of elevation and it flips real tight, real fast and nice. This is the transmitter, and I've talked myself silly over this transmitter with all the other Finecos that I've reviewed. And you know, I'm not going to say much more about it. It's just not designed very well. I will say it's grown on me. I use these quite a bit because I really like the FX-5W. It's that nano is so fun. I really like most of the Finecos that come with this. So it's kind of grown on me, and I don't really notice it much when I'm flying anymore. So even though it is weird, it does take a little while to get used to, but you eventually will. You plug the mic in here. It comes with this headset mic, and at first I was like, why is there an earpiece? And then it's because it talks to you. So when you give a command, it's when you say like take off, it'll repeat it back to you to make sure that's what you wanted. And if you don't want it, you can say cancel and it'll cancel the command. So that's why there's an earpiece. And when you start it up, it actually sounds like a jet starting up in your ear. Pretty cool. There's a couple sound effects. So it only has two speeds, and they're right here on the power switch, slow and fast. And there's one yaw, and it's not super great. It does come with the standard screwdriver pack with the spare props and the USB charging cable. And these extra prop rings and a very nice instruction manual, like all Fineco instruction manuals. Very nice, even though it's small, everything you need to know is in there. What else? I think that's about it. I really like this thing. I have a lot of fun flying it. This is a good indoor flyer. It's got all these prop guards and stuff. It doesn't, you know, you have to put it on high to fly it, so it gets a little squirrely inside, but you can definitely. I fly it inside all the time. But outside, it's really fun. It's a fun flyer, and it looks different and cool. So, all right, let's go outside, and I'm going to take you through everything, so it might be a longer flight demo because I'm going to take you through the pitch and the yaw. And then I'm going to put this in and show you some of the voice commands, and we'll call it a review. Hey guys, so this is going to be the flight demo of the FX-3V by Fineco, and you can recalibrate it like all the Finecos by holding the right stick down and doing a circle, and then the quad will flash and you're ready to go. So this has two rates. I'm going to take you through the pitch and the yaw. It's really windy, but I think we'll get through it. Take you through the pitch and the yaw, and then I got the headset. I'll do the voice command thing so you guys can check that out, and we'll get this thing finished. So this is low rates here, and this just has one yaw. So there's the yaw. Ooh. Get over here. So there's the yaw. It's only got one, so both rates, that's the yaw. So Here's the pitch against the wind here, trying to get it to move. Let's get it back out here a little bit. Here's the pitch. Doesn't have very much pitch in low. It is a little difficult to make it do what I want. So there's the pitch. All right. Very docile and, you know, slow. But I guess that's good for beginners. Okay, so now we got it in high. So here's the yaw. So same yaw. There's the yaw. Okay, so here's the pitch in high. So now we're talking. This thing has nice pitch in high. You can get this thing moving pretty fast, despite the big prop rings. Nice pitch. Even though it doesn't have a super fast yaw, the pitch kind of makes up for it in the turns, so it can turn pretty fast. Let's just do a little bit of flying here. This thing banks really nice. I really like this quad. It's just a lot of fun to fly. It's just fun. All right. Let's check out a couple flips before I do the voice control. Does really nice flips. I think I'll change out the battery just in case, because once it goes into LVC, it disables the flips, so then you can't voice control the flips. So let's get it over here and change the battery and check out the voice command feature. All right, so now I got the voice and it talks in your ear, it repeats back the stuff you say, so I got distracted, but I got the voice microphone on, so we're going to do some voice stuff. So the first command, and I'll just hold this up here, the first command is take off. Take off. So you can see it just takes off. So you do have to give it throttle. So. All right, so let's front flip, back flip, back flip, flip back. It's flip back, not flip, not back flip. Okay, so go left, go left, go right, go back. It just gives little inputs, so it doesn't give up. So like, go left. Well, that's flip left. Flip forward, okay. Okay. So it does have pre-programmed ones too. So there's ones like show two. Show two. wind caught it and I dropped it. Let's do it this way. So the shows and stuff are like pre-programmed things. One of them is a funnel, which is show two. So let's try it back here. So take off. Okay. Show two. Oops, I stopped it. Show two. So that's all the controller doing that. So, okay, so flip forward. Flip back. So let's try show one. Show one. Wow, that's show one right off the deck. So it does pre-program stuff. I'm just gonna finish. The voice works pretty good. It works good. It recognizes pretty much everything. That was crazy. I'm just gonna finish off this flight, this battery, with just some normal flying and battery's probably almost dead anyway. Yeah, it's already blinking, but prop card test, right? Durability test, whatever you want to call it. Wind's getting to it, battery's almost dead, so we'll call that a good one. Alright. Of course I messed up the grab landing. Alright, Fineco FX-3V. Pretty awesome little quad, so thanks guys.